So previous class we discussed about the phase lock loops. So these phase lock loops are important. So when you are actually integrating to the grid, or do you require a unity power factor or anything, right? So generally these phase lock loops are based on the synchronous reference frame theory based phase lock loops. So you already discussed that it consists of three important parts, right? It consists of three parts. So one is the phase detection, loop filter, and a voltage control oscillator. So phase detection, so we'll detect the phase angle, and this loop filter will eliminate that harmonics or it will filtering purpose, and this voltage control oscillator will generate the appropriate phase angle or phase displacement, right? So this is a basic synchronous reference frame theory based PLL. So this is the basic building block for any advanced PLL, right? So here we already studied that. So first ABC to alpha beta transformation and alpha beta to DQ transformation. So that is the things are in a synchronous reference frame. So we have this VD component and this VQ component. So this VD component contains the magnitude information, and this VQ contains the phase angle information, right? This phase angle information is given to a loop filter. So this is actually a PI, this is actually a PI controller, and this is a low pass filter, right? So that gives you the error in the or this that gives you the error in the So that gives you the error in the steady state error in the angular frequency. From that angular frequency, the steady state error is fed to a PI controller. So this is the error component, or this is the difference component. Under steady state condition, we can expect that, or ideally we can expect that this component will be equal to zero. Right. So this is the nominal frequency. This omega n is the nominal frequency. So for example, this signal or for this is connect to a grid, so we can expect the signal of 50 hertz, right? So therefore this one is related to this 50 hertz component, okay? This omega n is derived from this 50 hertz component. So this is the estimated angular frequency. By integrating this estimated angular frequency, you can get the phase angle, estimated phase angle. So with this phase angle, you can actually recreate the synchronizing signal. So again, for alpha beta to DQ transformation, that is for Fock transformation, you require phase angle. So that phase angle is obtained by this feed forward network. So from this, right? So here, there are some of the important parameters to choose a better filter. Some of them are this disturbance rejection selectivity. So that is one parameter. If any disturbance occurs in this primary in this input side, right, so that disturbances must be taken care. That is disturbance rejection selectivity. And another one is the filtering capacity. So this one actually takes care of this filtering capacity. So harmonic, next one is the harmonic extraction or harmonic isolation. So any harmonics that are present in the source side, so that must not be reflected on the output side. So another one is the dynamic response. Another one is the dynamic response. So how fast is actually tracking the phase angle? So that gives you the dynamic response. It must be as dynamic as possible. The thing is that when you are introducing the several filters like this PI controllers or this low pass filters, so that always delay the response. So we have to make sure that it is fast enough to change the or to improve the system dynamics. Another one is the computation burden. So most of these things are implemented digitally. So we have to make sure that it requires the less computation burden. So this is just PLL only, right? So apart from this PLL, we have other controllers, that is voltage controller or current controller and PWM controller, that also exist. So therefore, we have to make sure that it will not take most of that system burden, right? So another one is the noise immunity. So whenever there is some noise on the input side, so we have to make sure that, so that will be filtered out. So these are the main parameters, so that are actually required to take in care, or these are the, when you're selecting a proper phase lock loop. So first one is the disturbance rejection selectivity, filter capacity, filter capability, harmonic extraction or harmonic isolation, so dynamic response, computational burden, and noise immunity. Okay, so these are the basic parameters we need to consider. So when you are choosing a proper PLL, right? So here, so where the main problems that are occur is, first thing is in this filter, so that is the loop filter. Another one is this omega n. Okay, so this is nominal frequency. So that is the frequency that we are actually expecting, right? So for example, when there is a disturbance on this primary side, so this parameter also changes, right? Or when you are implementing some other different control techniques for the motor driver applications, in that case also this nominal frequency is continuously changes. For this, there are several ways is there. First one is to improve the dynamic performance, or there are the first one, this is I think this is the model of this model of PLL, this is already we studied, right? So this is the linear model, and another one is the non-linear model. So this sine parameter, so this is the non-linear model, and we are neglecting the sine wave because we assume that the angles are very small. So this is the non-linear model, this is already we studied. Okay, so here one of the thing is that, so to filter this one, we can use this moving average filter. So we can use this moving average filter, so here, to improve the performance or to improve any noise or harmonics that are present in the this input side. Okay, so we can use this moving average filter. So generally this moving average filter is having, we can write it in the Laplace domain, it will be something like 1 minus e to the power of, we have this window time, s by tw into s. So this is the moving average, this is the moving average filter window length. So this tw is the moving average filter window length. You might have studied this. So different filters you have studied, right? Okay. So we can also use this notch filters, or we can also use this low pass filter to eliminate certain high frequency components or certain low frequency components. So now the question is, if there is any changes in the frequency, or there's any changes in the nominal frequency, so how these can be taken care? So this is one of the method, that is the estimated frequency from PI controller by using integral output. So here, instead of giving that directly, earlier we directly given to this omega n, right? So instead of that, what we are doing is we have another minor loop for generating this actual grid frequency, or this actual omega z. This entire purpose is to improve if there is any disturbance in the frequency or angular frequency on this input side. So how we are taking care, so that is the thing here. Okay, so generally the more information is not required. So this is another way, to improve this estimated frequency or estimated angular frequency or this nominal frequency. So by using this extra component, by using this adaptive frequency estimation loop, so we can eliminate this. This is another method to improve the this means this loop filter. So what is this actually? What is this one? 1 by tau s tau 1 s plus by 1 by tau 2 s. What is this?
Compensator.
What kind of compensator?
The lead lag.
It's a lead lag compensator, right? It's a lead lag compensator to provide the one second to improve the dynamic stability. So all these things are to improve its compensation cap, to improve its compensation capabilities or these filtering abilities. Okay. So this is another one. Okay. We have this, for example, in case of motor drive application, right? This nominal frequency is continuously changes, right? For example, when you are implementing this V by F control method, in that particular case, this nominal frequency, that 50 Hz is no longer maintained, right? Based on the speed requirement, it is continuously changes. So under such cases, so this is a continuous variable. So rest of the things are same. Again, this low pass filter and this loop filter is remain same. This is extra thing to obtain the nominal frequency omega n. This is the extra thing. So that is required to obtain the nominal frequency omega n. So this is especially useful when you're actually using with induction generators or motor drive applications where the frequency, where the nominal frequency is continuously changes. Okay, so this is the one required. So here, by using this alpha beta reference frame, so here we can use this frequency detector. So that will give you the frequency. By using some filtering, we can actually give this omega g. This is the nominal frequency, so where it is continuously varying. So this is especially required. So when you are integrating an induction generator to a grid, or when you are working on motor drives, and it is actually feeding to the grid. Okay. So here these are the equations that are actually given to detect the frequency. We have this frequency detector is there, right? So this is to detect the frequency detector. So this gives you the frequency detector. So by using this alpha beta components, we can actually detect the frequency. So next one is this VCOless filter. So earlier we have this VCO, this VCO is there, right? So we can omit this VCO by with proper mathematical calculations. We can do that in alpha beta reference frame. Okay. So this is alpha beta reference frame. So here we are not using a synchronous reference frame. So ABC's components are converted to alpha beta by using this mathematical modeling or mathematical calculations. You can extract the phase angle magnitude. So this gives you the magnitude, right? This gives you the magnitude, and these extra calculations that gives you the phase angle, that is sine theta and cos theta. These phase angle, it will give you the phase angle. Okay, so these gives you the frequency. Okay, it gives you the frequency, magnitude or amplitude, and this phase angle. Okay, the thing is that so this is with only alpha ABC to alpha beta reference frame. We are not using the synchronous reference frame here. So every method is having their own advantage and disadvantages. So these are some of the methods, or some of the improvements for this conventional or this classical synchronous reference frame based PLL. So as we discussed, based on the computation burden, disturbance rejection capabilities, and other parameters, we can choose a proper PLL. Okay. So next we have the single phase PLLs. So next we have single phase PLLs. So generally these three phase PLLs are based on the 3-phase to 2-phase transformation, right? These are based on the 3-phase to 2-phase transformation. 2-phase transformation and 2-phase to DC transformation, right? Here we have alpha beta transformation and we have this DQ transformation. But in case of single phase, this SRF or synchronous reference frame theory is not used, right? The synchronous frame theory is used. Generally, this SRF is used only for 3-phase. So now, so how to generate the phase angle in case of single phase? So there are actually two methods are there. So one is power based PLL, power based PLL, and second one is quadrature signal generation based PLL. So one is the power based PLL, so another one is the quadrature signal generation based PLL. Okay, in case of power based PLL, so we can actually obtain the power. In case of quadrature generation signal, so this is basically synchronous reference frame only. The thing is that in case of 3-phase, you have this alpha beta components, right? When you're converting this, we have alpha beta components. In case of this quadrature signal generation, so this quadrature signal, that is the beta component, so we will generate externally by changing the alpha component by 90 degrees. Okay, so we'll generate a fictitious beta component by actually changing the or actually delaying the alpha component by 90 degrees. That will generate a auxiliary beta component. So from that, you can actually show it as a 3-phase signal. Okay. So first one is a power based PLL, right? So let us assume that this input, so it is in this form V sine omega I, that is the input angular frequency, T plus theta I is the angle, phase angle of the input. Okay. So this is the one. So we have some extra terms that is related to the harmonic terms. We have, let us assume, that third order harmonic, fifth order harmonic, and seventh order harmonic, and so on. So let us assume this is the input. Okay, so this is the fundamental component and these are harmonics, right? So this is the general input, so we can expect, right? So this omega I is the input angular frequency and this theta I is the phase angle of the input. Okay, right, so let us assume that this cos omega naught t plus theta naught is the reference or this feedback waveform, so that is obtained by the PLL. So this is the feedback waveform that is obtained by the PLL, right? So this omega naught is the estimated angular frequency of the PLL and theta naught is the estimated angular frequency or phase angle of this PLL, right? So ideally this omega I must be equal to omega naught and this theta naught must be equal to theta I, right? So ideally this omega I must be equal to omega naught and theta I will be equal to theta naught, right? But there is a small minute difference is there. The difference is almost negligible actually, right? So let us assume this is 1 and this is 2. So when you are multiplying this 1 and 2, okay, so when you are multiplying this 1 and 2, so that is VI into cos omega naught T plus theta naught. So if you do this one, so we have to multiply each and every individual terms, right? The first term is V sine omega I T plus theta 1. So that is the first term, V sine omega I T plus theta I plus, sorry, into cos omega naught T plus theta naught plus we have this components into this cos component, right? So when you are doing this first term, so it will be something like this. So this will be when you are multiplying it, so it is V by 2 sine omega I T plus theta I, I think minus omega naught t minus theta naught, right? This is the first component, agree? Plus sine omega I t plus theta I plus omega naught t plus theta naught. Is this correct? Multiplication of these two. Or this is the formula, right? Agree? That is sine A into cos B. This is the formula, right? Sine A minus B plus sine A plus B. Is this correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I think correct, right? Okay. If it is not correct, we can cross verify it. Okay. So ideally, right? So we have other terms, we'll come out. That means we have other terms are there, right? Some other terms are there. So that are double frequency terms or multiple frequency terms. So let us come to this first term. Right. So let us come to this first term. So generally this omega I and this omega naught, so practically are, this will be almost same, right? Right. So but there is a difference. That means this theta I. Okay. So these are the basic things, right? So when you are actually implement this one, so if you compare this one, this is almost equal, right? So therefore, this first term can be rewritten as, so V by 2 sine. So I assume that omega I equal to omega naught. So therefore, so this term and this term, so both will be cancelled out. So you can left with theta I minus theta 0. Okay. So generally, this omega I is approximately equal to omega naught and theta I is approximately equal to theta 0. Right. So here this difference is very small when compared to this one. So therefore, I assumed as omega I is omega naught. That means input and output frequency, angular frequencies are same. But so there is a little bit variation in the phase angles. Right. So therefore, you're left with this information. Clear? So come to the second term. Right. So what is the second term? It's the same thing. So this is omega I t. This is omega naught into t. We have this difference of these two terms, right? Okay. So now how these terms can be written as? How can you write these two terms? You can write like this, right? 2 into omega I t. Okay. I assume both are same, right? Therefore, theta I plus theta naught. Clear? Agree? It's clear? Yes, and this theta I and theta naught, these two are almost same. So therefore, we can write like this. 2 times the theta I. So therefore, we can write like this. Or I will write in the next step. So this term can be written as V by 2. Sorry, what is missing? Sine. Sine 2 times omega I t plus theta I. Is this correct? We can approximately write it because we are adding these two, right? So therefore, we can actually make it 2 times. These are all approximation, right? So wherever you required, so we are omitting that approximation. And wherever it is not required, we are actually neglecting that. Okay. So this is the first term and this is the second term. Right. This is, if you notice that this is the double frequency term, right? It is the double frequency term. So therefore, we have other frequency terms. So that is in the form of 2 omega I, right? So therefore, we have this 4 omega I, 6 omega I, 8 omega I, and so on terms will be there, right? So these are the other terms. Clear? Clear? The first term, this is the first term, Right, and this is the double frequency term. So rest of the frequency, the 4 times the frequency, 6 times the frequency will automatically come, right? This clear? So how this 4 times the frequency will come? So if we have this third 3 times the component, right? We have this 3 times the component, and this is omega naught, right? So if you are adding these two, you can get the 4th order frequency. This is the 5th order, and if you are add to the first fundamental, so it will become the 6th order, and this will be the 8th order harmonic component will be present. So this is the first component and this is the second component. If you notice that we already discussed that this is in this form V by 2 sine theta I minus theta naught, right? Theta I minus theta naught. So this contains the phase angle information. It contains the phase angle information, right? And this one is the double frequency component. So that will actually, we need to actually filter out. We need to actually filter out this double frequency component. So this can be written like this, V by 2. So since this angle difference is very small, we can actually write like this, right? Theta I minus theta naught. It's clear? Theta I minus theta naught. And again, if you are dividing with this V by 2 value, so that gives you this theta I minus theta 0 error or this component. After that, we need to give it a PI controller like this 3-phase, and this PI controller will make this difference 0. So that gives you this angular omega G or this omega, this one. We need to add this nominal frequency. So from that, you can actually obtain the omega or this difference, right? After that, integrate this one. So that gives you the phase angle theta dash or theta bar, right? The rest of the thing is same, right? So earlier we have this theta I minus theta 0 is obtained in Q-axis component, right? After that, we have given to a PI controller. The output of this PI controller will actually dictate this one. This is the one. We actually obtain the this, it contains this phase angle difference, right? So that is theta I minus theta 0. So that is given to a PI controller that gives you this error. And this actually we are multiplying with a, or we are adding a nominal frequency that gives you the estimated angular frequency of the grid. After integrating that, this is it. That means this remains same. It remains same. Clear? It's clear? So now the question is, so how to generate the this kind of signal? Right. So here this cos, this one, where this cos omega naught plus 3 is the feedback component, right? So we need to multiply this input component, its feedback component, and moreover we have this V by 2 is term, right? So that means we have this additional 2 we need to include, right? So here, therefore, this overall control, so it will be something like this. I will write from the other end. Okay, so this gives you the error component. Let us assume that, so that gives you this theta I minus theta naught. So let us assume that this is theta I minus theta naught component. In other words, this gives you this VQ component, right? Okay, so we can assume that this is VQ kind of component, right? It contains the magnitude or this phase angle information. So this is actually we have to give to a PI controller. So we have to give to a PI controller. So that gives you this error. And we need to add the nominal frequency or nominal angular frequency. So this is the error, right? So that gives you the omega G. Clear? Right. So here we need to integrate this one. Okay. So we need to integrate this one. So that gives you the estimated phase angle of the grid. Okay. Estimated phase angle of this grid. So here, so this one from this, right. So from this information, we need to generate this cos omega naught plus theta, right? This is the feedback signal, right? So from this, we need to generate the feedback signal. So therefore, we have to, this cos term is there. So this is the cos term. Okay. So for this term, right? So if you notice that you are getting this V by 2 component, right? So to make it V, so you need to multiply with 2. We need to multiply with 2. So this one is actually multiplied to the, or this is actually multiplied to the, where we need to multiply to this input, right? So if this is the input, or this is Vi. So this is the feedback. Clear? So that means this entire thing, it contains the phase angle information. It's clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That contains the phase angle information. So here, it not only contains the phase angle information, in addition to that, it contains the phase angle information plus some double frequency component. Right. It contains some double frequency component plus other frequency components. Contains the phase angle plus double frequency component plus other frequency component. So this is the fundamental. So this is second order, and we have this 4, 5, 4, 6, 8, and so on. If you assume that this is free from the even order harmonics. Okay. Clear. So this is the overall control for the single phase. This PLL. This is power based PLL. Since we are measuring the power, so that means this is the power based PLL. It's clear. Okay. So we can also use, if we assume that this is the input is the sine term, so we need to multiply with the cos term, right? So for example, if this input is the cos term, so we need to multiply with sine term, right? The input is sine term, we have to multiply with cos term. Clear? If the input is the cos term, we need to multiply its sine term. So what is the additional change you require? This is actually, this contains is theta I minus theta naught, right? If you use this cos term and sine theta terms, you may get this theta zero minus theta I. So therefore, we have to make sure that, so this is minus two. If you are multiplying with minus two, you can actually get this theta I minus theta zero. Clear? It's clear? So we assume that the input is in sine form and feedback, right? To obtain the phase angle or this phase angle information, we are multiplied with cos term. If you are assume that the input is cos term, obviously we need to multiply with the sine term. Okay. Then the problem is, so when you are doing that with this two, right, you will actually get this theta zero minus theta I. Okay. So therefore, to avoid that, we have to multiply with minus 2. So that means that gives you this theta I minus theta 0. Okay. This is just simple trigonometry, right? Sin A into sin B, or sin A, that is cos A sin B form. Is clear? So what is the drawback with this? What is the drawback with this is, it will not give you the amplitude information, right? It will give only the frequency, which will give only the phase angle information, but this will not actually give you the amplitude information. So that is the first drawback. And the second drawback is, it contains all this component, right? This is the fundamental double frequency and other frequency component. So we have to make sure that, so this filter is filtered out, or we have to add some additional filter here to filter out the all this double frequency component and other frequency components. Clear? So we have to add additional filter here to filter out this double frequency component and other frequency component. To eliminate this double frequency component, we already discussed that. So notch filter is generally used. Generally, a notch filter is used to eliminate the double frequency component. Right. This notch filter is usually designed for 100 Hz. If it is 50 Hz here, the notch frequency where you have designed for 100 Hz component. Okay. And to filter out the other frequency components, so this will not, notch filter will not generally, means it will not eliminate the other frequency components, right? So therefore, we can go with, instead of this notch filter, we can also use this moving average filter. We can also prefer this moving average filter. So you can observe that, so how notch filter and this moving average filter actually work. Okay. You know these plots, right? This frequency response in canceling the harmonics. So here this blue one is the, right, this blue one is the notch filter with quality factor of 10, and this green one is the notch filter with quality factor of 1, right? You know the basic, right? When your quality factor increases, the sharpness is also increase, right? The sharpness of the filter is increases, but the disadvantage is it will reduce the, or it will reduce the this window width, right? Or it will reduce the bandwidth. Okay, when you are increasing the quality factor, the bandwidth will be reduced. So here this is the window width when compared, this is for Q is 1, so whereas this one is for the, okay, so the, here this bandwidth is from here to here, right? So in case of this moving average filter, this is for corresponding to moving average filter. So the advantage here, the moving average filter is designed for 100 Hz. Okay, this is for 100 Hz, right? Where we are, the main harmonics or this main ripples that are starting from 100 Hz. So therefore we are tuned to 100 Hz frequency. So you can see that this moving average filter that gives you the, right, that gives you this, that means that gives you this ability to filter out the this lower order harmonics also. That means it can compensate or it can eliminate the sixth order harmonic, fourth order harmonic, eighth order harmonic also. But the notch filter is eliminating only the 100 Hz component, whereas this moving average filter, it is eliminating all the harmonics. Okay. You can see that how to select this notch frequency, right? Or this notch quality factor, notch filter quality factor. If you are using a high value of Q, the bandwidth will be reduced. If you are using a low value of Q, the bandwidth will be more, but it will reduce the sharpness of the filter. Okay. So generally, this moving average filter is preferred. So this is about this power-based PLL. This is about the power-based PLL for single phase. So generally here a low pass filter or a moving average filter or a notch filter is used to eliminate this double frequency component and other frequency components. Clear? So next we can also use these FIR filters, right? You can also use FIR filters or IIR filters instead of that. So each one is having their own advantage and disadvantage. Right? If you are using too many filters, so that will sluggish the response or it will reduce the dynamic response. So we have other one, so that is quadrature signal generation PLLs. Quadrature signal generation PLL. That is QSG PLL. Quadrature signal generation PLL. So this is also known as transfer delay PLL, TDPLL, that is transfer delay PLL. Okay. So how these are actually work on? See, it's simple. It's very simple. So we have this input. So this VA, VB, and VC, right? So we have this input, right? So earlier we have these two transformations, right? So this ABC to alpha beta, and this is alpha beta to DQ transformation, right? So from this, it contains the magnitude. This VD contains the magnitude information, and this VQ contains the phase angle information. So this is what we are using for a three phase, right? In case of single phase, you cannot actually transfer this component to the single phase, right? So therefore, but we know that in alpha beta reference frame, right? In alpha beta reference frame, there is a phase delay of 90 degrees that are present between this alpha beta and alpha and this beta component, right? So therefore, we can actually create a fictitious or some imaginary Q axis component by using some transfer delay function, right? So for that, if this is the input, right, we are using this alpha beta to DQ transformation is done, right? So this will be the become alpha beta, this will become the alpha component, right? So how this beta component is actually generated by using some transfer delay. So this will be the beta component. So how much delay you actually require? How much delay you require? 90 degrees delay you require, right? A delay of 90 degrees you require. In other words, is the time period by this much of delay we actually require. Okay. So this gives you the VD component and this gives you the VQ component. The rest of the things are same. We have this connect to a low pass filter that gives you the magnitude information. And this is also contains the frequency information or the phase angle information. So this is given to a PI controller, right? So again, so it is multiplied or this is added to a nominal frequency that gives you the estimated grid frequency and integrating this one. So that gives you the phase angle estimated. Okay. Again, the inputs for this one, you require two inputs, right? So one is the sine term and this is the cos term. So this will actually go here. Is clear? So this is quadrature signal generation based single phase PLL. So this is also known as transfer delay PLL. Clear? So again, this is a standard quadrature signal based PLL. So there are a lot of drawbacks with this one also, right? So here again, if there is an input, it's not a perfect thing, right? So again, this transfer delay is also affecting, and we are blindly fixing the transfer delay as 90 degrees, right? If there is any variations on the grid side also, this transfer delay is also vary, right? For example, let us assume it is exactly at 50 hertz, okay? If it is exactly 50 hertz, the time delay is 0.02 seconds, right? So that means for T by 4 delay, we need to divide it by 4, right? So let us assume that the grid frequency is changes to 50.5 hertz. So obviously this value will change, right? Okay, so this value will change, but we are kept a fixed delay, right? This is usually fixed delay we kept, right? So therefore, if there is any variation in this frequency, that variation is not actually considered here. So that gives you some errors or some deviations in the measured frequency. So therefore, there are several methods there to improve that. We'll discuss a few methods. Okay, this is the one what we discussed, that is the transfer delay based transfer delay based standard PLF. Okay, so we have this delay component, so that is converted to alpha beta. This contains the magnitude information, it contains the edge angle input. So when compared to the power based PLL, in power based PLL we don't have the magnitude information, but here we have this magnitude information. So magnitude information is must, right? So this is must when you are actually working on the grid frequencies, or this is magnitude information is useful in the PWM technique for generating the modulating signals, right? So this is another one, because we already discussed that if there is any variation in the frequency, because this fixed compensation or this fixed, we are generating with a fixed delay, so that gives you some errors or some deviations in the measured phase angles. So that can be overcome, so with this some minor feedback loop, right? So this is generated here. It is generated in two ways. One is this is another with this thing. You are generating this 90 degrees phase shift, and we are actually subtracting this one. So that gives you whatever that extra component or that error deviation is there. So that deviation is can be this gives some extra deviation, right? For example, this is changes, so that some extra deviation it is there, right? So the deviation is compensated here by using this additional loop. Okay, so there is another one to address this deviation. So this is IPT PLL. IPT is inverse path transformation based PLL. So this is inverse path transformation based PLL. So here the thing is that, so earlier we had generated the 90 degrees or this beta axis component from this point, right, by delaying it 90 degrees. So instead of that, so we are actually using this inverse path transformation. So how we are actually using that? So this is same, right? This gives you the magnitude, this gives you the direction. So we have this VD components are there, right? This VD VQ components, this VD VQ components are giving to a alpha beta reference frame. So that gives you this alpha component, and this gives you the beta component. We are actually feeding this beta component here. Clear? By using this inverse park transformation, we are actually generating this signal. Again, the rest of the things are same. For this inverse transformation, you require the sine and cos theta, right? So this is what where we are obtaining the sine and cos theta. So one goes here and the other goes here. So instead of generating a fixed 90 degrees component or fixed 90 degrees signal from the input, so we are actually generating this from a inverse path transformation from the this DQ component. That is actually, this is actually generated from the feedback signals. Okay, so this gives you the more appropriate. So in most of the cases, or most of the cases, we prefer this kind of PLF for single phase applications. Okay, is clear? So this is about this basics of this phase lock loops for three phase and single phase. So if you have any questions, you can ask me. Just remember this, most of the PLL are normally this kind of this inverse path transformation based PLL is generally preferred. So we have other complex PLLs also there, so that gives you the computation burden of this, those PLLs are very high. So we have that second order other filters also there, second order filters also there. You have any questions? Any questions?